90 years old and nine, the Lord appeared to Abram and said unto him, I am the Almighty God.
Uh-huh.
Walk before me and be thy prayer.
Mm-hmm.
And I will make my covenant between me and thee, and will multiply thee exceedingly.
See, this is where the covenant started. This is why I said, that's why I always give praise to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God of them. These are the bearers of the covenant. There's a reason for this. Go ahead.
And Abraham fell on his face, and God talked with him, saying, as for me, behold, my covenant is with thee, and thou shalt be a father of many nations.
See, you said a father of many nations. Meaning that he's the father of Ishmael, he's the father of Isaac, he's the father of Jacob, he's the father of Esau, he's the father of the Edomites. All these nations, Abraham is the father of. But it's only one particular nation that he chose to bear his covenant. That's us. Jump down to verse 11. I mean, 15, excuse me. Verse 15, excuse me. Go ahead, bro.
And God said unto Abraham, as for Sarah, thy wife, thou shalt not call her name Sarah, but Sarah shall her name be.
This is when the name changed, because she's going to bear a child. Abraham, he was Abraham in the beginning, but when he had a child, he's going to be Abraham, the father of many nations. He's going to have kids. Go ahead.
And I will bless her, and give thee a son also of her. Yea, I will bless her, and she shall be a mother of nations. Kings of people shall be of her.
See, that covenant started with Abraham and Sarah. She's going to be a mother of nations. A lot of nations are going to come out of her womb and from Abraham. Go ahead.
Then Abraham fell upon his face and laughed and said in his heart, shall a child be born unto him that is 100 years old? And shall Sarah that is 90 years old bear?
So he told him all this, and Abraham was laughing in his mind like, Lord, I'm 100 years old, how am I gonna have a child? But with God, anything is possible. With him, anything is possible. But this is the thing I want y'all to see, that he did not choose Muhammad's great-granddad, which is Ishmael. Now look at what Abraham said about his son Ishmael, and see what God said about that. Verse 18, go ahead.
And Abraham said unto God, oh, that Ishmael might live before thee.
He said, let Ishmael live before thee. I already got a son. But listen to what the Lord said. Go ahead.
And God said, Sarah thy wife would bear thee a son indeed, and thou shalt call his name Isaac.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
And I will establish my covenant with him for an everlasting covenant, and with his seed after him.
See what he said? My covenant is with you and Sarah. You're going to have a baby from your wife, Sarah. I'm going to establish my covenant with Isaac, not Ishmael. So if you're following this Arab religion, you're following Ishmael. You're following Islam. No, this is the God of Israel, which is the God of our forefathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. This is Isaac right here. He said, I'm going to stop the covenant with him. Go ahead, brother.
Verse 20. And as for Ishmael, I have heard thee. Behold, I have blessed him, and will make him fruitful, and will multiply him exceedingly. 12 princes shall he beget, and I will make him a great nation.
He said, Abraham, I heard you. I'm going to make Ishmael have 12 sons, and he's going to be a great nation. Why do you think the Arabs control all the oil over there in Palestine? That's Ishmael. Why do you think they control all this stuff? Why do you think they got all this money? He blessed them. It's Abraham's child too. But the covenant only goes with Isaac.
Come on.
The bearer of the covenant.
Hallelujah.
The bearer of it. Go ahead, brother.
Verse 21. But my covenant will I establish with Isaac.
With who?
With Isaac.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
Which Sarah shall bear unto thee at this set time in the next year.
You see what I'm saying now? Now, if you following Muhammad and Islam, these are not the bearers of the covenant. The bearer of the covenant is with Israel, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Those are the bearers of the covenant. Now, let's get a little more foundation on on Isaac's generation. Let's go to Genesis chapter 25. Now we got to do it like this. I know it's a lot of reading, but in order to get this, you got to know, you got to read.
That's right.
You got to read. You got to understand. Just lay the foundation. We're not going to cherry pick it. We're going to go down and make sure you understand. Genesis chapter 25, we're going to start at verse 19. Go ahead, brother.
And these are the generation of Isaac, Abraham's son. Abraham begot Isaac. Isaac was 40 years old when he took Rebekah to wife, the daughter of Bethuel, the Syrian of Padan, the sister of Laban, the Syrian.
Now we deal with Abraham and his son Isaac. He give you the generation of them. He tells you about their kids and what they had. He married a woman called Rebekah. And Rebekah gonna have Jacob. Go ahead.
Verse 21. And Isaac entreated the Lord for his wife because she was barren. And the Lord was entreated of him, and Rebekah, his wife, conceived.
See, she was barren, she was a war in her stomach. These two boys were going at it even in the summer. We talking about Jacob, and we talking about Jacob and Esau. These two brothers also. But we're not so much concerned about Esau, we're concerned about the Israelites and who was the bearer of the covenant. Go ahead.
And the children struggled together within her, and she said, if it be so, why am I thus? And she went to inquire of the Lord.
She said, why are these kids in my stomach? They're kicking, Lord. They are in here fighting. They hurt me. And he going to give them, he going to give her the message. Go ahead.
And the Lord said unto her, two nations are in thy womb, and two manner of people shall be separated from my body, from thy body. And the one people shall be stronger than the other people, and the elder shall serve the younger.
She had two nations in the womb, meaning that these two boys are going to be the father of two nations. That's Jacob and Esau. He's going to be father of two nations. But he said the elder shall serve the younger, meaning that the covenant going to go with Jacob, the youngest son. But we're going to look at that. Jump down to verse 26. We just get a little background on this, understanding that these prophets came from these gentlemen, these Israelites. Go ahead.
And the first came out red, all over like, and hairy garment. And they called his name Esau.
That's the first son. That came out red and called him Esau. Go ahead.
And after that came his brother out, and his hand took hold on Esau's heel. And his name was called Jacob. And Isaac was 80 years old when she bare them.
80 years old when she bare him. Them boys were fighting in the womb. He was trying to grab Jacob. He was trying to grab Esau and pull him back in because he wanted to be first. But the Lord said, the elder shall serve the younger. Go ahead, brother.
And the boys grew, and Esau was a cunning hunter, a man of the field, and Jacob was a plain man dwelling in tents.
Yes, sir.
And Isaac loved Esau because he did eat of his venison.
Isaac loved Esau because he was like a hunter. He ate of these animals that he brought him in. I would say that's a deer or whatnot, but I don't know. But he ate of the animals that he brought in. Go ahead.
But Rebekah loved Jacob.
But Rebekah loved Jacob. God already told Rebekah what was going to happen. He told already that you got two nations inside of your belly, and one going to serve, the elder shall serve the younger. The younger one that came out second, he going to have to serve him. That's Jacob. Gonna have, Esau is going to have to serve Jacob. Go ahead.
And Jacob saw pottage, and Esau came from the field, and he was faint. And Esau said to Jacob, feed me, I pray thee, with that same red pottage, for I am faint. Therefore was his name called Edom.
Now understand this now. When Esau came out, he was the first son. He was the one that's supposed to get everything from his dad. That's going down in most today. If you have a son, he's the one supposed to take over the business. He's the one supposed to be the bearer of all your assets because he's the leader. God, that's the proper protocol. But the thing was in this particular area that Esau did not like that birthright. And he's going to sell it for a cheap price. Let's look at that cheap price. Go ahead.
And Jacob said, send me this day thy birthright.
He said, send me your birthright.
And Esau said, behold, I am at the point to die. And what profit shall this birthright do to me?
He said, man, I'm about to die. Give me some meat. He going to sell the birthright, the blessing. Go ahead.
And Jacob said, swear to me this day. And he sweared unto him. And he sold his birthright unto Jacob.
He sold the birthright. You got a lot of preachers out here today that saying that Jacob is a trickster. He tricked Esau out of his bed. No, he didn't. He said, look, if you want it, sell it to me. And he said, okay, if you want it, I'm going to give you some soup. Bam. He despised the birthright. He didn't even want it. Go ahead.
Verse 34. Then Jacob gave Esau bread and pottage of lentils, and he did eat and drink, and rose up and went his way. Thus Esau despised his birthright.
He despised it. So you're going to hear a lot of these theologians saying that the word, the name Jacob is trickster. There ain't no tricks. He ain't tricking about nothing. He gave it to him. He's like, hey, you want this? If you want this, I'll give you the soup. And he gave it to him. He despised it. So let's go to Genesis chapter 32. Genesis chapter 32 and verse 1. Now let's see how the name of Israel came about. Where did this name come from? Are you going to find out? Jacob's name was changed to Israel. Because what? The father said, I only deal with my people. He gave you his name, Israel. Genesis 32 and verse 1. Go ahead.
And Jacob went on his way, and the angel of God met him.
You see what I'm saying? I just wanted to let you know that the angel of God met him, because a lot of people read this particular verse in verse 24, John 9 verse 24, and they think it's just a man. No, it's an angel that Jacob was wrestling with. Angel. Verse 24, go ahead.
And Jacob was left alone, and there wrestled a man with him until the break of the day. And when he saw that he prevailed not against him, he touched the hollow of his thigh. And the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him.
Now Jacob wrestled with this angel all night. He wrestled with him because he wanted something from him. He wanted something from him. This is what the adoption started. This is what God adopted us, the nation of Israel. Go ahead.
And he said, let me go for the day breaking. And he said, I will not let thee go except thou bless me. And he said unto him, what is thy name? And he said, Jacob. And he said, thy name shall be called no more Jacob, but Israel. For as a prince has thy power with God and with men, and has prevailed.
You see what he said? He gave him his name. That's why the name of Israel is so powerful. Because he said, thy name shall not be called no more Jacob, but Israel. For as a prince, has thou power with God and with men, and lest thou prevail. You see what he said? Our name and our people had power through our forefather, Jacob. That's what Israel came from. He gave his name. And you have a lot of brothers and sisters out here change their name to Israel. Israel, because they understand the book. Now you got to operate in society at the time, but a lot of brothers changed their name to Israel. And you got these folks inside of Islam who changed their name to Muhammad. Mm-hmm. Or these different Arabic names, because they piggyback off what you just read here, changing of the name. Mm-hmm. That's why they do it. Mm. This is the reason why. They cherry pick what they want. Now let's look at these 12 sons that he had. Exodus chapter 1 and verse 1. Exodus chapter 1 and verse 1. We're going to break this down as a child would understand. There are no other nation that you're supposed to get this Bible from. You're not supposed to get this Bible from Islam. You're not supposed to get this Bible from Farrakhan. You're not supposed to get this Bible from Elijah Muhammad, from a messenger to the black man. I understand these brothers did a lot to try to uplift their people. But the thing is, if you don't get it from Israel, one of us, you have gotten lies. Lies. So we understand this. We're giving you the foundation. So when you get them with these people, don't be afraid of them. Go in their book. And I'm going to show you in their Holy Quran, as they say, that they talk about our people, Israel. Exodus chapter 1 and verse 1. Let's look at these 12 brothers, these 12 sons of Israel, of Jacob. Go ahead.
And these are the names of the children of Israel, which came into Egypt. Every man in his household came with Jacob.
These are his 12 sons. And remember God said, I'm going to bless you now. And he had 12 sons from Rebekah and Leah, who was the mothers of these boys. Go ahead.
Reuben, Simeon.
There was another, Rebekah and Leah and two. He got four wives, I can't remember their names, but these are the sons that he had from these four wives. These are the ones that bear the covenants. Go ahead.
Reuben, Simeon, Levi, and Judah, Issachar, Zebulun, and Benjamin,
yes,
Dan, Naphtali, Gad, and Asher.
Go ahead.
And all the souls that came out of the loin of Jacob were 70 souls. But Joseph was in Egypt already.
So these are the boy, these are his sons that he had. 12 sons, which is the 12 tribes of Israel. We just giving a foundation with this. Understanding, these people are a special, very, very special people. Our people are very, very special people. Look at today. It's still some truth to that today. Everything that our people do, whether it's singing, whether it's dancing, whether it's playing football, who the greatest in it?
That's right.
We are.
That's right.
But we seem we can't get it right. Why? Because we're not following this book. We're not following this book. We don't know who we are. Mm-hmm. Our nation is a very, very special nation. Let's look at that. Let's go to Exodus chapter 19. Exodus chapter 19 and verse 1. You are a very, very special people. And the nations look at you. They want to be like you. But the thing about it, Israel go foolish, they want to get away from you. And me. That's what we got to understand. If you don't know what religion to go in, you will go in all these different types of settings. You will be a part of Islam. You'll be a part of it. Why? Because they had one prophet, which was Elijah Muhammad, so-called prophet, a black man, who taught this to his people, to black young black men and women, inside of jails. And it gave them a sense of empowerment.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Sense of empowerment. And like I said, a lot of stuff he said is not false. A lot of stuff he said is true. Tell you the truth, he said more good stuff about the Word of God than the average Sunday Christian today. Mm-hmm. But it got to go through Israel. Not Muhammad, not Islam. It's got to go through Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, because those are the special people of God. Exodus chapter 19, we'll start at verse 1. Let's look at how special they are. Go ahead.
In the third month, when the children of Israel was gone forth out of the land of Egypt, the same day came they into the wilderness of Sinai. For they were departed from Rephidim, and came to the desert of Sinai, and had pitched in the wilderness, and there Israel camped before the mountain.
This is the time when Israel of our people came out of Pharaoh's or the Egyptian slavery. And God took us to a wilderness to get us right to go into the promised land.
That's right.
But we went foolish at the time. He tried to give us the instructions, what we're supposed to do before we get to this promised land. He's going to tell you how special you are to him. Go ahead.
And Moses went up unto God, and the Lord called unto him out of the mountain, saying, Thus shalt thou say to the house of Jacob, and tell the children of Israel.
You see what he said? to the house of Jacob and Israel. They're two and the same. They're Israelites. These are the kids of Jacob, the kids of Israel. Listen to what he says to them. Go ahead.
Verse 4. Ye have seen what I did unto the Egyptians, and how I bare you on eagle's wings, and brought you unto myself. Now therefore, if ye will obey my voice indeed, keep my covenant, then ye shall be a peculiar treasure unto me above all people, for all the earth is mine.
You see what he said about us? We're going to be a peculiar people amongst all the earth. Why do you think these people want to be like you? Because this is a residue on us that still applies. It's something on us that they see. That they see. Because God made us a peculiar treasure. We're supposed to bear the covenant. We're supposed to preach and teach to all the nations. We're talking about the Arabs, we're talking about the Muslims, we're talking about the Gentiles, we're talking about all the different nations. That's what the government get from us. But what has happened now? We went and got it from them.
Come on, bro.
We went and got it from them. We got the Christmas, the Thanksgiving. We got the Kaaba song, which comes from Islam. We got Ramadan, which comes from Islam. We got all these different type of holidays, as you would say, from these different nations. But we didn't go here to get it from the priests, which is us. Listen to what he said, verse 6.
And ye shall be unto me a kingdom of priests, and an holy nation. These are the words which thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel.
See what he said? You are the priests. We are the priests. We're supposed to teach everybody. But everybody has taught our people. That's why we get beat down in the streets. Because God punished Israel more than he punished any nation. He said seven times more. Seven times more. That's why we don't get slapped on the wrist like the most of the Gentiles or the white nations. No, they're going to kill us and think about it later. Look at Trayvon Martin. Look at Marissa Alexander, who fired two shots in the air to protect her from a crazy hug. She get 20 years. Look at all that. That's why he did this to us, because we are the kingdom of priests who's supposed to teach the nation. But the nation never taught us. They said the same thing in the Quran. We forgot about the Quran. We deal with this green Quran. And that's what Allah tell you in their book, that you're supposed to come. It's in the Quran chapter 2, and we're going to start with verse 40. We're going to do 40, and we're going to do 47. Let's see if he says anything different. Go ahead, brother.
O children of Israel, call to mind my favor, which I bestowed on you, and be faithful to your covenant with me.
That's what he said, O children of Israel. This is in the Quran. He said, O children, why didn't he say, O children of Ishmael, or O children of Mohammed? He said, O children of Israel, because we're supposed to guide and lead everybody. He said in the Quran now. Go ahead. This is what he said now.
I shall fulfill my covenant with you and me. Me alone should you fear. And believe in that which I have revealed.
See what he said? He said, I shall fulfill my covenant with you. Will you, O children of Israel. Why didn't he say, O children of Mohammed? Or O children of Ishmael? No. It's all about us. Jump out of verse 47. Listen to what it said again.
O children of Israel, call to mind my favor which I bestowed.
He said his favor. Favor one in the book, the Quran. Go ahead.
On you, and that I made you excel the nation.
He said, I made you to excel the nation. You're supposed to teach the nation. We are a kingdom of priests. But the nation have taught up in their own book, he said. Go look to the Israelites for knowledge. Go look to them. But you can't say that today now. Israel will tell you all kind of crazy stuff. Have you eaten catfish, pork, swine, all that stuff. Have you eaten all that stuff? This, we supposed to be a kingdom of priests. Now let's look at Psalm chapter 83 in the Bible. You can read that. Psalms 83 in verse 1. I don't understand how a person that is a so-called black man or Israelite can be a part of this Arab religion. I just don't understand how you can do it, because you're going to find out just where we read the scripture that the heir to one of the first slave masters that enslaved Israel. That's it. Ain't nobody reading this book and then they threw away the Old Testament and tell them we read from the New Testament, all that stuff done away with. That's the reason why we're in the condition we're in now. Because it's all about that mean green, that money, making you happy. Then, so you can dig deep in your pocket and put it on the table for them. They ain't trying to teach you how to save yourself. They ain't. I've been in these churches a lot of years and I want to find God. I couldn't find him. I found all the other stuff, past the anniversary. I found First Lady. All this stuff they going past us, choir, all this stuff. Ain't even written in the book at all. They praise the men more than they praise the God of Israel. I tell you, don't even come up with no going past the anniversary with me. Period. I don't want nothing like that. At all. I just want to be an obedient servant of God and teaching y'all. And what these pastors doing today, they don't understand. You're supposed to be the servant to the people. Mm. But what the people doing today? They serve the pastor.
That's right.
They serve. I'm just like you. You just like me. I'm not more important than you. I ain't got no heaven or hell to put you in. And you ain't got nothing to put me in. Only God can do that. Mm. Well, let's get off of that right now. Let's go to Psalm chapter 83. In verse 1, Psalms chapter 83, and verse 1. And listen to what I'm saying. He said, understand this, the Arabs and Muhammad people, they learned from Israel. And most of all, they the one that killed us. They the one that put us in slavery. We're going to see this, and we're going to read some old history. Verse 1, go ahead, brother.
Keep not thy sight, O God. Hold not thy peace and be not still, O God. For lo, thine enemies make a tumult, and they that hate thee have lifted up the head.
See, they're making a tumult, meaning making traps for you. The enemy, they're making traps for you. We're talking about all nations. We're not just talking about Arabs alone. The white folks, the Gentiles, and all these nations, they're making traps for who? You and me, the Israelites. This is what the book says. Go ahead.
They have taken crafty counsel against thy people and consulted against thy hidden one.
You see what he said? They have taken crafty counsel against my people. They just like the Willie Lynch letter. The slave master took crafty counsel and dealing with the slaves so they can enslave you mentally just as well as physically. Mm. But the preacher ain't telling you that. Slave stuff is done away with. Yeah, slave stuff ain't done away with. That's why they give you probation. That's why they put you in the chain gang. That's why they're making all this money off of you. That's why the prison business is the biggest business, some of the biggest businesses in the world. Why? Because Israel are the hidden ones in there. They the one that making all this stuff in the world. Free labor. Go ahead. They take crafty counsel against you. Verse 4.
They have said, come.
This is what they said now. This is what the other nations said. Go ahead.
Come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance.
You see what I'm saying? They do not mention Israel in the church. They do not cut them off from being a nation of people. The Israelites gather on the Sabbath. The Israelites take part in the Passover, the Feast of Unleavened Bread, the Day of Atonement, Feast of Tabernacle, God's holy days. He said, let us cut them off from being a nation. When you're a nation, you're doing the same thing. Exactly. So what are they doing now? This Islam, they celebrate Ramadan. That's where they fasting. They got it from us, the Day of Atonement. Then they got this thing called, I ain't going to get all that. We're going to look at all this in history. Go ahead, brother. Finish that.
Verse 5, for they have consulted together with one consent. They are confederate against thee.
See what I'm saying? They are confederate. They join together. One thing about it, we got our odds against each other, the Gentiles, the Arabs, and all this and that, but we know we got to make sure we control them Negroes. We got to make sure we control them because they are the ones we don't want them to learn. They are the chosen people. I don't know, I bet people right now listening to this, they're looking and they're going to get their Quran and say, dog, they didn't know that was in there. Because they ain't read it. Put it in the book. They ain't going to read it. Israel ain't going to read it. They're just going to follow. I don't want you to follow me just because you like me or just because I'm Jeff. I want you to follow this book. Well, look at this. Look at who are the ones that enslaved us.
That's right.
Go ahead, brother.
The tabernacles of Edom.
Yeah, verse 6.